Hello students, welcome to NIRS education channel. Let us continue the lesson, Madam Rides the Bus. In our previous session, we came to know that during her return journey, Valli saw a cow lying dead roadside, and she came to know that that was the same cow which was running in front of their bus while they were moving towards the town. Seeing that, she became very sad and she came to know about the difference between life and death. A little while ago, that was a lovable and beautiful creature, but now it had turned into a charmless and lifeless thing. That made her very sad and she stopped watching outside the window. Just she sat glued to her seat. After that, the bus moved to village at 3:40, and she stood up and she said to the conductor that she would see him again. And conductor also said that she could come to have a ride on bus whenever she liked, and she must bring her ticket fare. Now let's continue the lesson. She loped and jumped down from the bus. Then away she went, running straight for home. Yes, after that she loped and jumped down from the bus and she went running straight for her home. When she entered her house, she found her mother awake and talking to one of Valli's aunts, the one from the south street. This aunt was a real chatterbox, never closing her mouth once she started talking. See, when she entered the house, she found her mother awake. Mother already awake and talking to one of Valli's aunts. She was talking to one of the aunts of Valli. The one from South Street, that aunt was from South Street. This aunt was a real chatterbox. That aunt was a real chatterbox. Chatterbox means the person who talks more. Never closing her mouth once she started talking. Yes, that aunt never closing her mouth once she started talking. She was talking too much. And where have you been? Said her aunt when Valli came in. She spoke very casually, not expecting a reply. So Valli just smiled and her mother and aunt went on with their conversation. Yes, then that aunt asked Valli, where have you been? And she spoke casually as if she did not want any reply from Valli. So Valli just smiled and her mother and aunt went on their conversation. Valli also did not give any reply, just she smiled. Yes, you are right, her mother said. So many things in our midst and in the world outside. How can we possibly know about everything? And even when we do know about something, we often can't understand it completely. Can we? Yes, the conversation was going between aunt and mother. Mother said, "Yes, you are right." About which thing they were talking earlier, we don't know. But at that time, she said like that. "Yes, you are right," her mother said. So many things in our midst and in the world outside. Yes, there are many things in midst us and in the world outside. How can we possibly know about everything? How is it possible to know about everything? It is impossible. It is difficult. And even when we do know about something, we often can't understand it completely. And there are some things we know about them, but we can't understand them completely. Okay. Can we? She asked, mother asked to aunt. "Oh yes," breathed Valli. At that time, Valli said, "Oh yes," okay, with breathing. "What?" asked her mother. "What's that you say?" Then mother asked Valli, "What? What's that you say?" "Oh," said Valli, "I was just agreeing with what you said about things happening without our knowledge." Then Valli replied, "I was just agreeing with what you said about things happening without our knowledge." Probably Valli told this thing in two perspectives, two views. One is, we know about death, but we can't understand death. For that reason, she might have told like that. Second one is, the things occurring in front of, around the house or in the midst of the house. But parents were not able to understand that. What is that thing? Valli's trip to the town. These two reasons might be there. Okay. "Just a chit of girl she is," said her aunt. "And at look how she pokes her nose into our conversation, just as though she were a grown lady." Then aunt said, "This is a chit of girl." Chit of girl means this is a silly behavior of girl, immature behavior of this girl, said aunt. "And yet look how she pokes her nose into our conversation." And she said, "See that girl, how she pokes her nose into our conversation." Poke her nose means take an interest in something that doesn't concern her. Actually, they were talking each other, mother and aunt were talking each other. In that, this girl was interfering. That's why aunt said, see how she is interfering in elders' talk. "Just as though she were grown lady." She was behaving like a grown-up lady, like that, aunt said. Valli smiled to herself. She didn't want them to understand her smile. But then there wasn't much chance of that, was there? Then Valli, she smiled to herself. She didn't want them to understand her smile. She didn't want to reveal the secret why she was laughing. Okay. Didn't want them to understand her smile. But then there wasn't much chance of that. But there wasn't much chance of that, was there? With that question, writer answered. There wasn't much chance of that means probably someone might have seen while Valli traveling in bus. They may come and they may tell that matter to Valli's parents. So that secret cannot be kept for a long time. Okay. With that sense, the writer said here, there wasn't much chance of that. Okay, let us stop here. We shall go for another topic in the next session. Thank you for watching.